God's law is God's law, and it's given by God, and it's good, and it's holy, and it has a purpose. Yes, it does. It has a purpose. In fact, it has several purposes, if you will, but none of them is to make you holy. Nope. Purpose of the law, when we talk about the three uses of the law, you can talk about the civil use of the law by which governments of the world basically punish evildoers and suppress evil, and this is actually a help for the gospel. Then you have the primary use of God's law, which is to show you and reveal your sin. Yeah, that's right. That's it. God's law is going to sit there and correctly point out that you are totally depraved. That you are, you are a sinner, you are not righteous, you are not good, you are, in fact, quite evil. And then there's a third use of the law, and it is only for Christians. The third use of the law, once you understand and believe and trust the good news, the gospel, that you are saved by grace through faith alone, your right standing before God does not depend upon your earning your salvation, but your right standing before God is earned by Christ and what he has done for you in his vicarious life, death, and resurrection for you. When you understand that, then the law loses its ability to accuse us and condemn us before God, because Christ has stood in the gap for us, if you would. And then what happens is that this law being silenced, it shows us what a good work is and what it looks like to live in freedom. And this is one of the important categories we have to keep in mind as Christians, and that is that slavery or sin is slavery. It is not freedom. And so the person who says, so what you're saying by saying that we're saved by grace through faith and totally by what Christ is, and you're saying we could do whatever we want. Now, technically, the answer is no, we're not saying that at all. And the reason for that is quite simple. Sin is slavery. It is not freedom. Christ has not set you free so that you can live in slavery. That doesn't make any sense. No, and he's set us free not only from the punishment of sin, but set us free from slavery to sin. So we now have the freedom to say no to the devil, no to our sinful flesh, no to the world, and live in freedom. And freedom, if you want to know what freedom looks like, you'll look at the Ten Commandments. Freedom looks like living the Ten Commandments. That's what it looks like. So, yeah, well, so this sermon, it has some good elements to it. It also, it doesn't properly distinguish law and gospel, and as a result of it, despite the fact it has some really good things, at the end, it's going to end up burdening you rather than setting you free, which is kind of fascinating. So,